Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music
with Andrew Master.
So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Jailhouse here in Hereford. Now, this next artist is a 21-year-old singer-songwriter from Hereford. She's been playing and singing since she was 13 years old and is influenced by acts as diverse as Paramore, McFly, and Katy Perry. She's from Hereford. Put your hands together for Natalie Holman.
Hello. Thank you. This is my debut single, Butterfly. I wrote it in memory of my nan, so I dedicate this song to her today. I hope you like it.
You were never afraid to fight through it all, even when life knocked you down. You were always standing 30 feet tall. I hope that one day I'll make you proud. She's just like a butterfly.
Beautiful thing, you gave me a strength to carry on. I just wish you hadn't gone. She's just like a butterfly, so delicate and beautiful. My next song that I'm going to play, it's called Who You Are. I wrote this because I kind of struggled with being myself and keeping my individuality when I was in school and college. And I kind of wanted to inspire some people that it's okay to be yourself and it's better to not go with the crowd. So I hope you like.
Just be who you are. Cause that's when you'll go far. Every time she looks in the mirror, she doesn't like what she sees. where you'll go far. Just be who you are. That's where you'll go far.
Thank you.
Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
So we've come out the back of the jailhouse here in Hereford. This is the smoking area. It's got a bit of tarpaulin up at the moment, some sheeting. It's blowing in the wind. It's been hammering down with rain. You know what? What makes it better is looking at this shiny pink guitar of Natalie Holman's. That is pretty special, isn't it?
It is pretty fabulous. It's a Daisy Rock guitar. I'm actually endorsed by them. You can't say fairer than that. It's pretty amazing.
You are endorsed by them?
I am, yeah.
Okay, how does that come about?
I kind of wrote to them and said, thanks for the guitar. I bought it from Music Plus just down the road. They checked out my YouTube videos and it all kind of clicked into place.
So what does that mean?
Well, I get a free guitar.
Okay.
I'm appeared on their website as well.
Nice.
They're based in Los Angeles and they're just expanding over here, so it's pretty cool.
So any gigs lined up in LA?
Not yet.
You need to ask them.
I should, shouldn't I? I'd love to go over there and just to see it anyway, but to perform over there would be amazing. Okay. You never know. 2014 might hold that in my future.
So you're 21 now. You started making music when you were about 13 years old. You're a Herefordshire lass.
I am, yeah.
Tell me a little bit about kind of your musical journey so far, what you've done.
I started singing when I was like teeny tiny. I always wanted to be like the Spice Girls. And then when I was 13, a little band came into my life called McFly, so that kind of inspired me to start learning guitar, and I'd always go and watch their tours and everything, and that was where it kind of kicked off from there. Then I kind of started writing songs sort of mid last year really, so it's not been like a long time for me writing songs, but it's quite new. I kind of finally had the courage to do it and to try and make a real go of the music career.
And what was it like when you suddenly thought, okay, let's try and strum some chords, let's try and put some words together. Was it an easy process?
Well, Butterfly is like pretty much the first song that I wrote. It kind of just happened. I had these ideas in my head and I just had some chords that I thought might go with it, and it kind of all worked together. But otherwise, it is quite a hard process. It's not easy. I try and sit every day and try and write a song. Usually when I'm at work, a song comes into my head, so I can't really write it down. But then I just kind of go home and think of what's been in my head, and I pick up the guitar, start singing a few words, and piece it all together bit by bit. But it takes time, practice, and hard work.
Especially when you're working during the day. What do you do?
I'm a sales assistant.
Okay, what do you sell?
Shoes.
Okay, and when you go into these shoe shops, there's always music playing in the background. Is that your music? Have you managed to slip a CD in yet?
I haven't yet. Do you know, I haven't had the courage. My managers have been down to the shop, so you never know.
I'm just suddenly realising that I brought you out here. It's absolutely freezing. It's January, and you kind of got your stage attire on. I should check out these shoes then if you work in a shoe shop. Oh, yeah. Pretty glamorous. High heels, black. You've got three different straps on them. Yes. How many shoes do you have?
Not many, to be honest.
Do you not?
No,
I'm not. Mind you, you've got the shoe shop is almost your wardrobe, is it?
I'm not really high maintenance, so it's not too bad. I kind of just have a few trainers and maybe occasionally a few heels if I'm feeling glamorous.
But when you got a pink guitar, I was kind of expecting you to be wearing pink shoes and just everything to be pink. So you're not one of those.
No.
You're not a Barbie.
I'm not Barbie, I'm not fairy princess, no. I tend to be quite 50s style. I quite like wearing a lot of black and gold. I thought I'd put a bit of red on today and just try and look
very Christmassy.
Even though I'm not really Christmas anymore.
Well, we're before the 12th day of Christmas. We've got, what is it? It's the 5th today, so we've got till tomorrow.
That's all right then.
I'm
okay.
I'm going to wrap it up there because, as you've witnessed, one of this bit of tarpaulin keeps gathering rain and then it suddenly chucks it down, and Mike's taking our pictures and it's right where he's standing. So I don't want to get him absolutely soaking wet for the sake of an interview, but thank you once again.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
BBC introducing In Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Master.
Be part of it.
My next song I'm going to sing is called Toy, and I'm kind of hoping it might be my next single.
Trying to escape.
final song tonight. It's called Boy Like You. I wrote it ages ago with the help of my guitar teacher at Music Plus, and I hope you like it. I've kind of switched it up, but this is my acoustic version.
I'm Spike and I'm from Birmingham. It's a good venue, isn't it?
Okay.
We've just heard Natalie Holman. What did you think of her? I think she's got a lot of potential, hasn't she? She's written some really nice songs. I think she's going to be pretty good in a couple of years.
I'm Andy. I'm from Worcester.
You heard the J-Lo. Is this your first time here, Andy?
It is indeed. Fabulous place. I thought she was very good. She's very current.
I'm Pat. I'm all the way from Malvern today. I thought her voice was stunning, and you can really tell by her lyrics what she's writing about. She's very personal, her lyrics, I think. Stunning, yes.
Yeah, very nice. Really good voice and good lyrics to the song, and seems like a nice person as well.
I'm Ben from Worcester.
We see the size of the PA.
Yeah, I'm loving that. Nice, right?
Just heard Natalie Holman here at the J-Lives in Hereford. What did you think of her?
Beautiful voice, a great use of chords as well. I really like the songs. It's real nice to listen to.
I'm Harry from Worcester. Really nice voice. Really delicate songs. I'm into that.
Listen to the best interviews online.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.